I'm Norihisa Usui of Meteorological Research Institute of Japan Meteorological Agency. First, I'd like to express my thanks to organizer for inviting me to speak here today. So today I'm going to talk about 4D-bar assimilation system with a high-resolution coastal ocean model. Now JMA is operating a regional ocean forecasting system with MRIKEN WMP. It has been operated since 2008, and it covers Western North Pacific with a horizontal resolution of about 10 kilometers. And the data assimilation technique is based on 3D bar, and the major target of this system is mesoscale phenomena in the open ocean, such as coastal meanders, oceanic current, and mesoscale eddies. However, due to the limitation of model physics and the model resolution, it cannot represent coastal processes. The typical scale of coastal processes is about 10 kilometers in space and a few days in time. And this figure shows a temporal and spatial scale of various oceanic phenomena. And the present operation system covers this area. It covers mesoscale eddies and the wind-driven saturation. And JMA has now operating a storm surge model. It is actually very high resolution model, but it is based on a barotropic model, so it cannot represent the coastal barochronic processes. As a result, as you can see, there is a gap between the coverage of this system. So various coastal processes cannot be represent this operational model. For example, we have Typhoon Samba in September 2012. This typhoon approached to the western part of Japan and passed through the Japan Sea. And after the passage of this typhoon, coastal trapped waves were excited and propagated along the coast of Japan Sea. It caused a significant sea level rise up to about 50 centimeters. But the present operational system could not represent this process. In addition, in 2011, we had an abnormally high sea level event in summer. At that time, we had a sea level anomaly exceeding 30 centimeters, and it caused coastal flooding like this. So in terms of coastal disaster prevention, this kind of coastal forecasting, this kind of forecast coastal phenomena is really important. So for those reasons, we have newly developed a coastal system to cover this area. So before introducing our newly developed system, I would like to show you ocean observation data used for data assimilation. We are now utilizing these kind of ocean observations. Satellite altimeter observe the sea level anomalies by which we can estimate temperature and salinity in the ocean interior. And the satellite SST is also very important data for monitoring temperature field in surface layers. And the in-situ observations, especially algal profiling network, is a very important data for capture the large scale ocean circulation variability. And this map shows the observation point of algal profiling float of 2 days ago. And now we have about 4,000 algal profiling float in a globe. So it is very important data for large scale circulation variability. But if you look at the Western North Pacific region, you know, you see that there are few observations near the coast. And the bottom panel shows the observation point for the satellite altimeter. Altimeter provide a dense observation along their orbits, but you know that available data is limited to the open ocean, and because observation data is contaminated near the coast. So, of course, we have observations other than this kind of data, but the number of available data is so limited. So there are a few observations in coastal waters around Japan. It is actually a large issue for coastal data simulation. In consideration of these observation issues, the basic idea for our coastal system is like this. We have developed two models. One is analysis model, and the other is a forecast model. And data simulation is performed with the analysis model. Its resolution is about 10 kilometers, and actually this resolution is the same as the present operational system, but the analysis scheme was upgraded from 3-diba to 4-diba in order to improve short-term mesoscale variability, which is actually very important for interactions between coastal seas and the open ocean. And the forecast model is based on a high-resolution coastal model with a resolution about 2 kilometers. And we utilize up-to-date numerical schemes, and we also incorporate initialization scheme in order to initialize the forecast model using the 4-diba analysis field. And this is a schematic view of this assimilation cycle of these two models. So first, we developed a prototype system. Its target area is Seto Inland Sea. Seto Inland Sea is located in western Japan around here, and here is Kobe. So Kobe also faces the Seto Inland Sea. And this system consists of two models, 2-kilometer coastal model and 4-diba analysis model for the western North Pacific. And this system has already been implemented at JMA in June last year, and now in a trial phase. So we are now moving on to the next generation system. And the next generation system, the model domain is expanded to cover the whole Japanese coastal region with a resolution of 2 kilometers. And this system will be in operation several years later. So the coastal model used is based on the MRI community ocean model. And we made a number of improvements compared to the present operational model. For example, we employed the ZISTA coordinate system, which enables us to set more realistic coastal topography for shallow waters. And we also introduced explicit tidal forcing, which is also very important in coastal circulation. And also river runoff is also very important in coastal waters. And we now plan to utilize the JMA's product called JMA runoff index. This is calculated by a hydrological model using precipitation data, and it covers a number of domestic rivers like this. So the data accumulation, I'd like to start with the previous 3-diba scheme. This is the cost function used in the 3-diba analysis. And this function consists of 4 terms, a background term and 2 observational terms and constraint terms. And by minimizing this function, we optimize temperature and salinity field. However, the control variables are not temperature and salinity themselves, but the amplitude of vertically coupled temperature salinity EOF mode, denoted by Z. This vertical mode is obtained by applying an eigenvalue decomposition to the background error covariance matrix. To be specific, if we decompose this background error covariance matrix in vertical direction, this matrix B is represented by these matrices. This matrix U is composed of the vertically coupled EOF mode. And this matrix lambda is a diagonal matrix of similar values. And this S represents background standard errors. So this background term is transformed like this. If we compare this form with the background term written by Z, you see that this part corresponds to the Z, the control variable. So by after optimizing Z, we get optimal temperature and salinity increment by using this relation. So this is an example of the vertically coupled temperature and salinity EOF mode calculated in this area. As shown here, we divided the model domain into subregions. And for each subregion, we calculate this kind of this vertical mode. And actually, this dominant mode can be understood as a dominant reading dynamical mode, such as the first and second baryonic mode, and so on. So in this, in our system, in vertical direction, the background error covariance matrix is modeled by the vertically coupled temperature salinity EOF mode. In contrast, in horizontal direction, the background error covariance matrix is modeled by a simple Gaussian function. And we set the zonal and the meridional correlation scale based on the previous observational study. So this is our 3D bar analysis scheme. Then we, the 4D bar was developed as a natural extension of this 3D bar scheme. So we use the same B matrix as 3D bar, and also the temperature and salinity vertical EOF mode are also used in 4D bar. And the one of characteristic of this 4D bar scheme is to incorporate an initialization scheme in order to suppress spurious noises arising from dynamically unbalanced correction increment. So in addition, we developed a combination algorithm of 3D bar and 4D bar. In the standard 4D bar, the 4D bar iteration start with a zero increment. In contrast, in this combination algorithm, we first perform 3D bar analysis. Then the descent algorithm start with the 3D bar analysis. So here we compare the two experiments of 4D bar. First is the top panel shows the 4D bar only case, and the bottom panel shows the case with the combination algorithm. Here we compare the temperature increment at 400 meter depth. So we see that two cases show a very similar structure. Actually, if we look at the cost function, two cases converge to almost the same value. But the case with a combination algorithm have a large advantage in the beginning of the iteration. So this combination algorithm enable us to obtain higher accuracy with a smaller number of iterations. This advantage is very useful for operational use because computational time is limited for in operation. So next, in order to confirm the impact of the 4D bar, here we compare the 3D bar and the 4D bar analysis field. On the left panel, we compare the SSD field. During this period, this warm water intrusion event occurred around here. This event was caused by the crucial current fluctuation. Actually, this kind of warm water intrusion is very important for the coastal ocean. And you see that the 4D bar succeeded in reproducing this event, but the 3D bar failed to reproduce. And we also compare the sea level variation at this tidal gauge station. You see that our result captured well the observed sea level variability. And we also compare the power spectrum of the sea level variability at this tidal gauge station. You see that our 4D bar result shown by this red curve enhances the short-term variability with a typical time scale less than 10 days. In addition, we conducted a comprehensive comparison between 3D bar and 4D bar, and we found 4D bar is really effective to improve the short-term mesoscale variability. So next, I'd like to show you an initialization method for the forecast model. And we employ the initialization scheme of the Incremental Analysis Update, IAU. The IAU initialization is performed according to the following steps. First, the forecast model is integrated from the initial time to the center of the initialization period here, then compared to the analysis field to take a misfit. After that, the misfit is divided by the number of time steps during the initialization period here. And finally, the forecast model is again integrated with the correction term, this term, during the initialization period. By repeating this procedure, the forecast model is expected to reproduce the actual oceanic variation, like our analysis model. So in order to check this analysis, this initialization, here we compare the two models in the top panel between analysis model and the forecast model. This is SSD movie. You see that two models show the very similar mesoscale features, such as the cross-shore meanders, like here, and mesoscale eddies. In addition, forecast model represent the smaller scale features, which are not represented in this analysis model due to the limitation of the horizontal resolution. And for comparison, in the bottom panel, we plot the satellite-based SSD map. You see that this satellite map, SSD map, so smooth temporally and spatially. So next, we check the smaller scale features in the forecast model. Here we compared with the satellite high resolution satellite SSD image. If we look at the smaller scale features like this, forecast model seem to succeed in reproduce these kind of smaller scale features. Of course, we need more further evaluation, but this is a promising result. So the coastal sea level is also an important target of this of our coastal system, and this map shows the correlation coefficient between coastal tide gauge observation and our forecast model. And you see that our model has a very good result. At most tide gauge stations, the correlation exceeds 0.9. And this figure shows the time series of the sea level anomalies at three tide gauge stations. You see that our forecast model well captures the observed sea level variability. So in addition, we performed a case study. This is to reproduce an abnormally high sea level event that occurred in 2011. At that time, sea level normally exceeds 30 centimeters at around the Seto Inland Sea, and the coastal flooding occurred. This is the Itsukushima Shrine located here. So in the bottom panel, we compare the sea level anomaly at three tide gauge stations. And this gray curve shows the tide gauge observation, and this red curve shows our forecast model result. And this sea level rise corresponds to this event. And you see that our model will capture this sea level rise event. And also, our model result clarifies its mechanism. This movie shows a sea level anomaly calculated by our model. And you see that this event was caused by this cross-shore fluctuation. Cross-shore current fluctuation generates coastal trapped waves accompanying high sea level anomaly. It propagated westward along the south coast of Japan. This is the cause of this event. So finally, I'd like to mention the future perspective of our coastal system. As mentioned before, the horizontal resolution of analysis model is still 10 kilometers, and so the target of data simulation is still mesoscale variability. So for coastal, so we need coastal scale data simulation for further improvement. So based on the geostrophic adjustment theory, velocity observation become very important in coastal scales. In addition, not only geostrophic, but also ageostrophic component become important in coastal scales. So we need velocity assimilating velocity data is indispensable for coastal scale data assimilation. So the one candidate of velocity data is high frequency radars. The observation coverage is so limited, but we have several ocean radar sites in Japan. The other candidate observation is a new satellite. Now, some aerospace agencies are planning to launch new satellites that observe the high resolution two-dimensional surface topography, which are expected to capture velocity signal, not only geostrophic, but also ageostrophic component. Furthermore, forcing field such as wind, such as surface wind and river discharge are very important in coastal scales. Here we compare two surface field of the JMA's operational atmospheric model. A global model on the left and a mesoscale regional model on the right. In synoptic scale, you see that two fields are very similar structure, but in coastal scale, you see that there are large differences between them, probably due to the difference in representation of coastal topography. So if we compare the power spectrum for wind stress field on the left and the ocean surface current on the right, we see that the systematic difference at the shorter time scale. So we need high resolution wind field for coastal system, but there is still large uncertainty in wind forcing in coastal areas with complex coastal topography. To improve this situation, one possible approach is to correct atmospheric forcing as one of control variables. And also river discharge is also very important for coastal circulation. And here we compare two cases of experiment with using the different river discharge data. The color shows the surface salinity and the vector shows the surface current. And one case is using the climatology river discharge, and right side shows is a case with JMA's runoff index product. You see, and if we compare with the satellite-based salinity field, this JMA RI case is more realistic. But if we compare with JMA's RI and in-situ river discharge observation, this runoff data still has a large bias. So there is room for improving this runoff data. So one possible approach is to collect the river runoff data using ocean observations such as salinity data. It is a challenging topic, but for the future data simulation study. So in summary, we have developed a coastal system. And this system consists of a forecast model and analysis model. And the forecast model is based on a high resolution coastal model, and we utilize up-to-date numerical schemes like this. And we also incorporate the initialization scheme. And for analysis model, we employ the 4D bar analysis scheme, and we also employ the TSUOF mode for beam matrix, and we also developed combination algorithms, and we confirmed 4D bar is really effective for short-term mesoscale variability compared to 3D bar. And towards the coastal scale data simulation, we need data estimation of the velocity observation. And we also need to take into consideration the forcing uncertainty. So that's it. Thank you for attention.